Welcome to part 4 of our video series. We'll continue our review of the PCI Express Gen 5 specification-based IBIS-AMI models. My name is Todd Berman-Solo. I am an application engineer here at Keysight in the Design Engineer Software Services Group. In this video segment, we'll cover an overview of an IBIS-AMI simulation and walk through some ADS and SystemVue results. Let's begin. This is a high-level overview of components in an IBIS-AMI simulation. The traditional IBIS file is present in both TX and RX. It models the analog driver and termination effects. The interconnect channel is all the passive elements in the system, the on-die routing, the package, the board, the connector, cables, etc. The newest item, the AMI, is the compiled C++ executable. For transmitter, it models effects like gain and feedforward equalization. On the receiver, FFE, CTLE, DFE, and clock data recovery, or CDR. The AMI blocks don't understand voltage or current, just real numbers. What happens first is the EDA simulation tool solves for the impulse response of the transmitter IBIS plus channel plus receiver IBIS, and that together is considered the channel response. That channel response is combined next with the transmitter AMI behavior, and then finally the receiver AMI behavior to get a complete response. For details, let's take a closer look at the convolution-based channel simulation. IBIS-AMI supports two simulation flows. First is purely LTI, or linear time invariant, using impulse responses and convolution to create a system impulse response by which the EDA simulation tool will consume to generate eye diagrams, waveforms, and or bit error results. The process is captured on the top of this diagram, going from step 1 to step 2 and finally to step 3. The next simulation mode is bit by bit or time varying mode. The process still starts at step 1 with the channel impulse response, but progresses to step 6, where it's convolved with the stimulus plus the transmitter get wave response, and then finally to step 7, where the receiver get wave will provide final waveform processing. The output of the bit-by-bit mode is a data waveform plus sampling point information in the form of a clock time signal. With that, the EDA simulation tool can directly output waveforms or construct eye diagrams and bit error results. Next, let's look at the simulation results comparing ADS versus SystemVue. To verify the generated IBIS-AMI model, the behavior from SystemVue is compared to the results in ADS. This is an important step to identify any errors or C++ conversion mismatches. For instance, the model may run fine in SystemVue, but on export, if you set, let's say, floating point values as integers, then you'll see a different behavior in your compiled C++ model. This definitely happens more often when you are new to the tools, but it can still happen to experienced users, especially in a complicated model set with many features to manage. So correlating your results between tools gives you the confidence that no errors were introduced in any step of the process. So what's shown here is the setup and channel sim for ADS to use these IBIS-AMI models. So let's have a look at some results. First, let's look at the short channel results. Selected was a minus 12 dB at 16 GHz insertion loss channel. The impulse response was extracted from ADS and imported into SystemVue. The TX and RX models are run in SystemVue and produce the purple waveforms shown in this lower left-hand graph. After the TX and RX models are compiled to IBIS-AMI through the code generator, then they are loaded into ADS and run with the same channel to produce the blue waveforms. You can see the excellent agreement on both the receiver input and receiver output eye diagrams. Also shown is the ADS bit error rate analysis. Next, the long channel results were checked. Again, the impulse response was extracted from ADS and imported into SystemVue. Similar to the short channel, good agreement on eye diagram overlay with long channel. The minus 36 dB at 16 GHz represents the max loss that a PCI Express Gen 5 agent needs to support, which makes sense with the model behavior. So we're seeing the results of 14 millivolts and 14.38 picoseconds. The pass-fail eye needs to be 15 millivolts and 9.375 picoseconds at a bit error rate of 1e to the minus 12. In this correlation case, the transmitter EQ and the receiver CTLE were not swept for optimal values, so this isn't the best value to expect, but you can see its performance is where you would expect it to be for this maximum insertion loss case. This concludes part 4. Please join me for the next video, and we'll continue to explore these PCI Express Gen 5 IBIS-AMI models. Thanks. Thank you.